I've read that one before, and we just move right on past it, don't we? I've seen that verse before, Sister Shelley. I've read it before. But I don't know about you, but if God is telling me tonight that I have the wisdom of God locked up on the inside of me, and it's a wisdom that was foreordained before the worlds were ever formed, before anything was ever put together, and I have been given the ability to speak the wisdom of God in a mystery, I don't know about anybody else, but I want to know how to do that.
Amen.
Don't you?
That's right.
I want to know what kind of mysteries it is that I'm speaking out of my life in order to see these unclaimed blessings now manifested.
Right. Right.
Hallelujah. God help us in the place tonight. Don't get religious on me, church.
Come on. Come on.
Read this stuff right out of the Bible. You know, we're not just making this up.
Bring it on. Come on.
Hallelujah. Speak and see. What does that mean, Lord?
Thank you, Jesus.
Speak wisdom of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
What does that mean, God? I don't know how to speak mysteries, Lord. What does that mean? I'm going to tell you, I've read some of these verses half my life and never questioned some of it. You know, one of those moments when, I've read that before. Just keep right on moving, Brother Scott.
Right.
Never gave a thought to it.
Bless you, Lord.
But I come back to this. I speak the wisdom of God in a mystery. So I went and I pulled out my concordance. You know what I mean? And I just went right down the line here. And I looked at all these other verses that would begin to speak to me about speaking mysteries. And this is where I landed. Look at 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 2. For he who speaks in a tongue does not speak to men but to God, for no one understands him. However, in the Spirit he speaks mysteries. So tonight we understand, church. We either understand or we are reminded. There are two categories of people in the house tonight. Some of us are being reminded of this, and some of us are just being enlightened on this. But tonight the Lord reminds us that there is another piece of the purpose of having been baptized in the Holy Ghost of God with the evidence of speaking in tongues. See, some of us have been in church all of our lives, and we've watched Pentecostal people pray in tongues, speak in another language that nobody could understand but God. Some of us, we were raised up in church, in churches where people did that. You went to school, you didn't know what to tell your friends because all the people in your family and all the people in your church family spoke in tongues. But tonight, God wants us to understand that there are some secret things that are locked up in the secret place, and he's given us the ability, the divine access, the way to access those secret things,
right,
to pull those things out of the secret place,
right,
so that we can access those things. Amen.
Amen.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Yes.
Praying in the Holy Ghost is not just a church time experience.
Come on. That's right. That's right.
We need to get out of the bed, Brother Scott.
Come on.
And pray and allow the Holy Ghost to pray through us.
Come on. Yes.
When we're in the car and we're ready to drive to work, we need to allow the Holy Ghost to pray through us. You know why? Because we may not know what the day holds, what's out there in front of us, but the Holy Ghost already does.
Right.
He's already out there. So it's not just something that we do when we come into the house of God. It's not just something that we do when we're in our private prayer closet. But we need to access that wisdom of God.
Yes.
We need to release those mysteries, that our faith for mysteries.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He's already prepared things for your glory.
Thank you, Jesus.
He's already prepared things, Brother Mark, for your advancement. He's already prepared things for your highest level of achievement.
Yes.
He's already prepared things for your prosperity.
Right. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Well, Sister Jeannie, we had someone tell us not too long ago. They said, "Well, I was raised in another denomination, and I love the church where I'm going right now. I just have never seen a need to be baptized in the Holy Ghost. I've never seen a need to pray in tongues before. Why would we have to pray in tongues? Because see, when we pray in tongues, we are accessing the wisdom of God, the wisdom that God ordained for us.
Come on.
We have locked into that wisdom that's been hidden away for us. It's hidden away. Why is it hidden away, Sister Jeannie? Why is it locked up for us? And I'm ready to just come out here and run around a little bit, but I don't want to knock anything over up here. But so why is it locked away? Why is it hidden away somewhere? I believe that it is because it is the only dialect. Come on, church, we know this. It is the only dialect. It is the only language that the adversary of our soul cannot interpret and cannot understand. See, we get out of bed in the morning and we pray and and we say, Lord, I've got three children and I've got a husband and we're in this a little apartment and you've got to get me out of this apartment. And that's how you pray. You pray in the English language, but the devil has the ability to interpret that prayer language. So it begins to go and set up roadblocks in order that you cannot get out of that apartment, in order that you cannot get into the house that you're calling on God for. But honey, when you get out of the bed in the morning and you begin to pray in the Holy Ghost of God, and I'm going to go shut up higher, and it's almost like the devil's running around somewhere, and he says, I'm going to hold up high. I don't know what it is she's saying over there. I can't hear what it is she's saying. I don't know what it is that I've got, what kind of roadblock to set up, and the devil cannot come nigh you, and God begins to take you straight into your destiny.
Thank you, Jesus.
That's it. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
God help us.
Yes.
To get a hold of this tonight.
Oh, yes.
You know what, church? Can I just be honest with you? Some of us have been in church for so long, and the Holy Ghost is so familiar to us that he has become common.
Come on. Come on. That's right. That's right. Preach it. That's right.
Hallelujah. There is nothing common about an uncommon God.
Come on. Right. Hallelujah.
Nothing common about him. Everything about him is uncommon. Yes, we recognize his presence.
Hallelujah.
But we don't ever want the God of the universe to become common to us. So common that we treat him like he's common. Hallelujah. See what we're doing, church. When we pray in the Holy Ghost, we are believing God for things that we don't even have the knowledge to know how to ask him for. Amen.
Yes.
We got one more verse of scripture. You all want it?
Come on. Yes. Hallelujah.
It's Jude verse 20.